Hello everyone. In continuation of the Laplace transform, we'll be studying and getting concepts clear of the second shifting theorem. So by the end of the session, you'll be able to evaluate the Laplace transform of the given functions using the second shifting theorem. Okay, what is the statement? The statement says that if the Laplace transform of f of t is f of s and g of t is equals to f of t minus a, and this g of t is defined under the two intervals, that is t greater than a and t less than a, where the t less than a, the value of this function g of t is 0 and it has some value. What that some value is? It is f of t minus a for the interval t greater than a. Then the g of t is equals to e to the power minus a s into f of s. So what is the extra term? I have to do it with this. So that means what? In prior, I have to have the Laplace transform of this f of t. So Laplace, if the Laplace transform of f of t is f of s and the g of t is defined with the help of f of t, right? Because this g of t is nothing but f of t minus a for the interval t greater than a, and it is 0 otherwise. So then the Laplace transform of g of t is equals to e to the power minus a s into f of s. So this f of s, along with this f of s, term, we have to write it down whenever we are dealing here with the second shifting theorem. Okay, so now let us go for just run through this theorem. This Laplace of f of t is 0 to infinity e to the power minus st f of t dt, which is the definition of the Laplace transform. Now this f of t is getting replaced as this g of t, but what is this g of t is defined as? This g of t is having the value 0 to a. Under the value 0 to a, it is the value as 0 that is given to you here. And the value of this g of t under the interval a to infinity is f of t minus a, right? And that what we have done. Now, what would be the substitution? Always, because I would like to write down this Laplace transform of g f2, I have to define in terms of f of s, right? What is this f of s? Is nothing but the Laplace transform of f of t. That means I have to approach my proof in such a way that somewhere I will be coming, I'll be reaching to the definition of a Laplace transform. And therefore, I don't want this f of a as, I want that as f of the variable. And that is why we have taken the substitution here. T minus a is equals to x. So again, I have to note it down this step here. That is, I have to take the substitution as t minus a is equals to x. And dt, therefore dt becomes dx. And what will happen with the limit if t is equals to a? Because this is the limit here. When t is a, that time x becomes 0. Just by putting it, when t is equals to a over here, so this a minus a, my x will be 0. And when t is going to infinity, my x will also move to infinity. Now, this Laplace transform of g of t, which we have been coming from this tape, after the substitution, we'll be getting this. So we'll be getting this 0 to infinity e to the power minus s a plus x. What we are doing, we are just putting the values of after the substitution. So our variable is moving from t to x. How much and how? It is t minus a is equals to x. By that moment, it is moving. So we are just transforming our variable from t to x, variable of integration. Okay, so this is what Laplace of g of t is e to infinity e to the power minus s a plus x. This is f of x and dx becomes, so this is dt becomes dx as we have shown it here in the previous, which is e to the power minus a s 0 to infinity e to the power minus s sx f of x dx. What we have done, we have just taken out the constant, which is a constant with respect to x. What is a constant? Whenever I, now here in this present case, x is the variable of the integration. So other than x, the other variables are the constants, you can say. Other alphabets can be the constant. So that we can take it out. So e to the power minus as is coming out of this integration sign, and rest of the thing is nothing but 0 to infinity e to the power minus st f of t dt. I just showed this. It doesn't matter. This is not the substitution. Remember that. This is not a substitution, just to make you feel of writing this as a Laplace transform. What I have defined it here, I have just made, just replace every x by t, nothing else. There is no substitution is done. And therefore, this is the value as e to the power minus as into f of s, right? And which is what is following the second shifting theorem. Now, let us move for a few examples. First of all, find the Laplace transform of g of t, where this cos of t minus a, t greater than a, and it becomes 0 when t is less than a. So now, the purpose they have put the statement, this entire statement over here. If the Laplace transform of f of t I'm aware in the beforehand, then it is very easy for me to get to the g of t, the Laplace of g of t. Now, just come back here. It's a cos of t minus a, cos of t minus a. So what is the function over here given to me? The function is given to me, that is f of t is given to me as cos of t. And cos of t, Laplace of cos of t is we are aware of. And therefore, Laplace transform of f of t, which is our f of s from this step, which is s upon s square plus 1. And therefore, the Laplace transform of g of t would be just by simply putting e to the power minus as s upon s square plus 1. And now in the present case, this a has been given to you as a only. Most of the time, sometimes it might be cos of t minus 2, t greater than 2 is equals to 0, t less than 2. So in that case, the value of a becomes 2. And if the value of a over here is 2, then obviously it would be e to the power minus 2s. So that would be the change. So according to this value of a, this multiplication factor will come over here, right? Okay, then one more, I was just talking about this. Now it's a g of t sine t minus pi by 4, right? T greater than pi by 4 and it is t is less than pi by 4, the value becomes 0. Here, now you have to just remember and understand what the function we have got it here. We have got the function as sine of t. So f of t is equals to sine of t. We are aware of the Laplace of sine of t as 1 upon s square plus 1. And what is the value of a over here? In the present case, the value of a is this. This is what is the small a, right, in this present case. And therefore, that is the only change we have done it. E to the power minus pi s by 4 into the Laplace of sine t, which is 1 upon s square plus 1. The second shifting theorem is very, very simple and it has many applications. As I have told you the first lecture itself, in the introduction of a Laplace, there are many applications in the almost every area of the engineering and the real life situations. So this is very important to have an understanding of the Laplace transforms. And this is, come back to our self-observation. So these are the three examples I have given it to you. You have to identify f of t out of it. You have to find out the Laplace transform of that f of t. And just while putting the Laplace transform of this given function. Now here the purpose they have given you this function as f of t. I have not given you a g of t. So what would be here? I have to have understand that, okay, this is what is my, I'll just do that. I should not make any change to that. You will not get confused. Okay, so this is f of t is equals to t minus 2 the square. So just don't get confused with the notations of g of t or f of t. Sometimes it might be given by other notation. Don't confuse with that. You have to understand the sequence of that function. That is, it's f of t is defined for t greater than 2 and it is 0 for t less than 2. Similarly, it is defined into pi by 3 by 2 pi by 3. And it is not there for t less than 2 pi by 3. With that, you have to understand, yes, this is the question of the second shifting theorem. And we can easily apply the second shifting theorem in this type of examples. Answers are also there. Just cross check. Brainstorm here. Just don't come and listen to the video. It's of no use then. Understand and bring your come up with your own notes. Thank you. Happy learning.